Waging War on Corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ukrainian forces destroy Russian convoy. I mean, this is escalating so fast. Hey, we ought to queue up the end of the Ray McGovern interview from a few days ago, where he said it ends with thermonuclear war. This is beyond the Cuban Missile Crisis. Hope and change turns to rage. Shooting a black youth comes amid dire social disparities. My concern is black-on-black crime is anywhere on the statistics from 5 to 12 to 14 to 7 to 9. I mean, the numbers all vary, but you can look up the Justice Department's own numbers. Black-on-black crime. No one gets upset in Chicago when three or four black people get shot a day by black people and killed. More than 15 a day get shot on average. Look it up. Don't believe me. Type in how many people get shot a day in Chicago. It's about 15, about three or four die a day on average during the summer. It's a couple less during the winter and other months. I mean, I know these numbers. I see them every day. The numbers come across the desk here. Why is no one, I mean, it's like, why aren't the black people upset about 52% of blacks being aborted before they're born? No, they only get upset when a cop shoots a black person, even if it's a black cop shooting a black person. And, I mean, yeah, the cops do lie about it. Sometimes they shoot black people in the back and then lie about it, like what we saw in San Francisco. And it's the lying that then makes the public not trust police. So what are the police doing? I want to ask Joe Biggs this. We're going to go to Josh Owens coming up. Joe, this is not how you win the hearts and minds. Like we said 3 days ago when you first got there, this is going to escalate things. Now we have demonstrations nationwide, them attacking reporters. And now, sure enough, they're saying that the reporters thank them. Al Jazeera thanks them and that they were there helping them with rubber bullets, tear gas, and flashbangs. And they were there helping them with their equipment when they told them turn it off and dismantle it. I guess the Washington Post reporter eating at McDonald's who was arrested by paramilitary and slammed into the wall, I guess he was being helped as well, Joe Biggs.
Joe Biggs here, Infowars.com, Ferguson, Missouri. I agree with you. I mean, I've never heard of protect and serve in that manner. You know, entering a McDonald's and then slamming a reporter, that's out of this world. That lets you know that things are starting to fall apart. The other day was just complete and total lawlessness by the police officers here. I mean, they were looking for something to do. They wanted to use that equipment they had. They got that stuff from Washington, and they were itching to use every single thing that they had.
What would happen with your tours in Iraq and Afghanistan if you guys acted like this?
Well, someone would probably call in to one of their Taliban buddies, and then probably within 15 to 20 minutes, we'd be ambushed from all directions and eventually die. You don't treat people like they're animals. You know, the other day they had everyone cornered into an area and then pointing rifles at them. How do they expect people to react when there's a sniper rifle at them? And a lot of people are saying, oh, these guys are thugs, they're thugs. Tell me how you would react at home if someone points a sniper rifle at you, at your chest, or your child. How would you feel?
I got to be honest. I mean, I don't think it's good what they're doing, but as a man, at a primitive gut level, you've got to admire people that'll throw bricks or pieces of brick at police when they're aiming machine guns at you. I mean, you got to actually say those folks are, that's pretty ballsy.
Well, one of the guys told me something. He's like, if you're passionate about something enough, you're willing to die for it. And he said, we're willing to die for the justice that we want. We're willing to die so we don't have police brutality in our town anymore. He's like, I'm willing to take a bullet from one of these officers so my daughter can grow up safely, so we can make a change to get these corrupt officers out of here.
Yeah, for those that don't know, we're going to come back and talk to Joe on the other side. For those that don't know, there's been a lot of allegations of police brutality and out-of-control behavior. And the force is like 60 people. Only three of them are black. So I think that's the big issue here. We'll be right back.
I'm David Hall, founder of Diamond Gusset, where we are proud of our 100% grown and sewn American-made jeans. Whether you're out for dinner, working on the farm, or on the road, Diamond Gusset Jeans offers a full spectrum of style and sizes for any occasion. Our loyal customers enable us to continue sponsoring Liberty Media outlets. Use promo code FREEDOM to receive a 15% discount at gusset.com. In Liberty, David Hall, Diamond Gusset Jean Company.
Tell folks how you got introduced to Super Male, and then when Super Female came out, tell us what happened.
After I saw such a huge positive change in my husband, I had to try it for myself.
Talk about the effects.
I feel great when I wake up in the morning. I have drive to go to the gym. I feel like I look better. I feel better. I feel sexier. I love it.
Even if you don't believe in supplements, take the challenge. Get a bottle of Super Male, a bottle of Super Female. Check it out for yourself. Consult your physician. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. This is life-changing.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security by sticking our hands down on pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch, the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the InfoWar to the next level. From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Well, I tell you, it's really shameful on all sides here. The looters, the people calling for killing the police attacking Washington Post, Al Jazeera, InfoWars.com reporters, and then coming out on Fox News today, we read the statement earlier, and saying they were assisting the media when they overran us and tore down the TV equipment. We have HD footage from both angles. They said, turn your cameras off, charge hundreds of yards, firing, attacking. There's video of all of it from the front and back and side. Just absolutely ridiculous. And then separately, you've got locals saying that they saw Michael Brown with his hands up, being shot in the back. But then other witnesses said there was a scuffle on the ground with the officer by the police car. And it's beginning to lean towards the police at least telling the truth partially. But how do you know that when they lie so much, folks? I mean, Al Jazeera said they were terrified, shot, chased their car, guns pointed at their heads after being tear gassed for no reason. Our reporters were there. And they're saying that Al Jazeera thanks them. Al Jazeera says that is not true. I mean, again, this is just getting ridiculous. But this is breaking up on InfoWars.com. Ferguson cops say Michael Brown robbed store before he was killed. And now we're seeing some of his online photos and things that we'll put up on screen. And he looks pretty pretty thug life, ladies and gentlemen. But police released surveillance video, stills allegedly showing teenager choking the shopkeeper. You know, I love how thugs always rob these chains where the shopkeeper couldn't be armed. They don't do that to the mom and pops. Because let me tell you, I mean, I can fight, but if somebody comes in and starts trying to assault me, I'm not going to get in a physical altercation in my business. I'm going to pull a gun out and say, get out of my store. And if they try to assault me, I'm going to shoot them. And that's why the store got torched by the thugs who put snitch on it, because the word got out that he dared call that the guy came in and was snatching merchandise. When the shopkeeper tried to stop him, because they get fired if they don't, he began choking him, and you know, basically, because he was three times bigger than the shopkeeper. And again, we need to post in Watson's article the photo of Brown that's up on Drudge. Can we punch that up right now from Drudge on the left-hand side? Hope and Chain turns to rage. And it's the whole thug life, you know, F-U to the world attitude. MSNBC's done the regular deal of trying to show photos of when he was younger, just like with Trayvon Martin. Again, it's all part of each side lying and manipulating as much as they can. I mean, we could get up here on air and lie as well. I don't want to do that. I want to really try to find the truth. So what's the final equation here? The globalists are manipulating this whole symphony and trying to get demonstrations going nationwide so Obama can be the peacekeeper and the referee and try to call for calm while his surrogates, Al Sharpton, the Justice Department, and others, run around stirring up as much racial animus as they can, because he hasn't delivered to the black community. He had delivered to anybody but the offshore globalist. So all they've got's race now. And black folks are turning against Obama all over the country. And white folks are turning against the political system and the rhino Republicans. So what do? You get Fox News making it racial, making it about Al Sharpton, shelling the police state that everybody's waking up to as something that's, well, for those black people, so it's okay. No, it's for everybody. What you do to the least of me, you've done to me, as Christ said. You can do this to poor people, you can do it to anybody. So that's what's going on here. Okay, yeah, we've beeped out some of that there. But that's the type of stuff that's going on. But that's not even the real criticism of... They're saying, where's Sharpton at? Well, he's hanging out and can hardly walk back doing a press conference. Obama has his Justice Department there stirring things up. While all this is happening, Ukrainian forces have destroyed a Russian convoy and are saying it was military. The Russians are saying it was aid. And the U.S. is sending 600 troops, APCs, and tanks to surround the Russians. To quote, reassured threatened allies. This is really cruising towards military conflict. They got missile cruisers off the coast there in the Black Sea menacing the Russians so that Russia can't respond to a first nuclear strike. They're trying to push the Russians into attacking us. We have high-level intel. That's the plan. We have missing nuclear weapons out of Dyess Air Force Base. You notice as soon as we reported that, all hell broke loose and they said, yeah, there are nukes on the East Coast. Al-Qaeda is going to bomb us with them if we don't attack Syria, when Syria is the opposite group than Al-Qaeda. We're under nuclear blackmail, folks. We don't even know the full extent of what's going on, but it's very serious. The borders are down. The dollar's being devalued. All these wars are starting. The globalists are announcing our kids belong to the state. The surveillance grid's out in the open. The NSA spying on the Tea Party. It is getting crazier by the minute. And we need cooler heads to prevail and not let the next shoe to drop be race war, burning cities, and Obama calling in Homeland Security as the referee while his surrogates stir it all up. I really wonder who they're hiring as police officers, though. With the 70-man paramilitary team with the MRAPs there in Ferguson. Oh, these are for Al-Qaeda. First chance they get, they're out there.